morning to all of you. Today, those who have submitted the copies, notebooks, all of you have submitted notebooks. So those who have submitted the notebooks, you can. Okay, I will try to bring it here. Otherwise, or before you go, you can come there. That if I did not bring it during the class, then you come there after that. Where you are, I am sitting there in 9th class, you know, that 8th class is the 8th B class. There you can come and collect your copies. Okay. And those who have not come to school, they can collect it tomorrow. Those who are at home, you can inform. I have already messaged them, so they will get the information. Okay, so the next we have to study is about a poem that is on killing a tree. On killing a tree. So you might have been surprised to hear the word written like killing a tree, you know. So you have heard like cutting a tree is already very familiar, but here it is given about killing a tree. So do you know what is the difference between cutting a tree and killing a tree? If normally, if you are cutting a tree, what happens? If you cut a tree, what happens? It will not die, isn't it? So what happens is that if you cut a tree, then from the roots or from the stem which is remaining there, from there another tree will come up, isn't it? So it will start growing because its roots are there, and only from the top portion if you are cutting, then it will not die. So you know, see, like trees are there. Like we are living maximum up to 60, 70 or up to 100 years, even to the maximum extent we can live, isn't it? But the trees are there, they are living for many years, hundreds of years, isn't it? So there are trees, some techniques and all are used for calculating the like a life of a tree. They cut it and there are, each year there are different layers are coming on the skin, on the body, or the stem is made like that. You can, when you cut a tree, if you can see, there are so many circles are there. So each circle indicates each year. Okay, so many circles are there. So we cannot just count it like that. But those who are experts, they are able to understand that. And how many circles are there, and how much is the duration, or how long this tree has been there. So you can find that tree, and even if, as I told you, even if you cut a tree, it is not going to die. It will come up. But what we have to do for, or how the tree is being cut or killed. So that is what we are discussing. Okay. It takes much time to kill a tree. Not a simple jab of the knife will do it. It has grown slowly, consuming the earth, rising out of it, feeding upon its crust, absorbing years of sunlight, air, water, and out of its leprous hide, sprouting leaves. Okay, so here, so it is given like it is. It takes much time to kill a tree. So it is the poet says that it takes a lot amount of time for killing a tree. It is not that easy that we can kill a tree. You know, so people if we have to kill a tree, there are lot amount of processes, lot amount of time is required for killing a tree. But cutting a tree just by a jab means to give, like cutting, no? When you are giving one beat, like not a simple jab of the knife will do it. So just by one time if you cut it, and then it is not going to die, you know. So if you cut it, just if you cut one branch, like if we are there, if our hand is cut, or legs are cut, or any accident is taken place, any part of our body is lost, then it is lost forever. But trees are not like that. If you cut a branch, another branch will come, isn't it? So that will grow, and the same branch may not be there, but another branch will be there. If you pluck a flower, then other flower will come, isn't it? So such a way, some plants are there, once like this banana and all is there. So once fruit is taken, that plant is over, isn't it? So like that, there are some plants, small plants are there, but trees are not like that. Trees are bigger, and if you are cutting the flower or cutting the taking out the fruits or whatever we do, it is not going to die. It will continue, and it will be staying there. Just by giving a jab of knife, it will not die. It has grown slowly consuming the earth, rising out of it. So the growth of the tree is very slow. You can see, like if you want to, if you plant a tree, it is said that like if I plant a tree, it is not for me that we are planting, but for our next generation. So like if you are planting, you might have seen that the fruits that we are eating is not of the plants that we have planted, mostly. So we are getting mostly, nowadays we are purchasing the things from the market. And even if it is there in our own, like in our farm, if there are some trees are there, some mango trees or some other trees are there, and where we are getting the fruits. But these trees are not planted by us, you know. So if we got something, then we have to also plant some more trees. Okay, so it, you know, see, like the growth of the tree is a very time consuming process, you know. It is not growing just in one day or 2 days. Or as I told you, like if the plants that we are, or the fruits that we are getting is not planted by us, but it is maybe our parents or our grandparents might have planted this one, or even we don't know who has planted it. It's like some mango tree, some other plants are there, some trees are there. They are we are getting the fruits, but we don't never search from where we are getting it. You know, so we don't worry about those things from where we got it. Like if you, like if you are eating food, so it is the effort of the farmers, and there are lot amount of people. If you are eating a chapati, in that like there are farmers, those who are worked in the field. There are like some tractor, one who is riding the tractor, there is a effort of that person is there. There are those who are making fertilizers, there are companies, those who are working in the fertilizers. And after the production, there are like when wheat is completed, then there are for cutting, there are again machines are used, and there are people coming for doing that work. Then after that threshing work is done, then it is taken to the mill. Then mill or in the factories, they are making it into powder and atta. So for that, there are so many laborers working for that, you know. Then after that, they are processing it into like some branded atta and all, and it is coming through the marketing system. So there is like a wholesaler will be there, retailer will be there. There are so many shopkeepers, those who are trading with that. Then after that, it is purchased by some of like your father may be there. He is going to the market and purchasing and bringing the atta, and your mother is preparing it and you are eating it. So when you eat it, you know, don't see that this much long process is there, isn't it? You eat a chapati and you think that your mother is cooked and it is made by your mother. But it is not only your mother, but it is a long process, you know. So many people are working under that. So likewise, a tree is growing not just in one day or in a few days or even not in a year. So if you plant a tree, those who are good in, or those who are interested in planting trees, like if you put a seed, you will be going and when I was small, I used to plant the seeds or like some plants and all. I used to plant it like rose and all, you know. So I will plant one rose, one stem I will cut from somewhere and I will come and plant it. I was very small at that time. So I used to plant it. Then I will wait one day, first day I will put water and see whether it is started growing or not. 2-3 days I will see, and after that still now, if the that bud has not come, I will open it and see whether root has come or not, isn't it? So then after that again plant it, and again 2-3 days I will wait, again lift it. So this process used to be done. So after that only my parents told that if you remove, then it will not grow, you know. After that 2-3 times if you remove, then by the time it will dry. So you have to wait, you know. It is not that one day you plant it, tomorrow it will start growing. It is not like that. Okay. And one plant I, for this winter, I purchased some plants online. Okay, I purchased some buds, some winter plants I wanted to cultivate. So I purchased some, around 400 rupees I spent and purchased some buds, you know, some, these ones are there. So that I purchased, so a few plants are there, like, and I purchased and I planted it. I purchased some pots also and planted it in the pot, and I was watering. Then it is, I purchased around around 35 bulbs were there. In that only 2 or 3 has come up. Still I don't know whether they have not died at any means, but it took around 2 weeks time over. Till now it has not come up. I have to open and see whether it is their roots are there or not. So it is not growing and we feel so much pain, isn't it? So like you have planted some plant and if it is not coming up, we feel pain. But I planted some other plants are there and one plant is there called Morning Glory, one flower is there. So I planted it and it started growing and when I planted only 2 leaves were there on that. It's a very small plant I had planted in a pot. And it started growing. After a few days, I found that another leaf has come. Then after that, it started growing. I gave a support for that. And it started rotating like that and growing. And first it was only one circle. And then after 2 circles, now it became little big. And now it started to give flowers. So when we feel, when you plant a plant or a tree, or in my home, I have some trees are there. Okay. So like some mango trees, here also I have planted one or two mango trees are there, one guava tree is there, so in that our compound we have planted some. So when we are planting one tree and it will start growing, we feel so much amount of happiness, isn't it? And it is not that one day it will not grow or it will not give fruit in one day, or even it will take a lot amount of time for growing it, but we feel a lot amount of happiness when you see like one leaf has come, it is very happy we will be feeling. Then after that it started growing, another leaf will come and it will start, new branches will be coming. So I have, as I told you, I planted some trees at my home and every year when I go home, I go and see that plant. Now this is like mango trees and all are there which I have planted and it is giving fruits. And I am not getting fruits but I know when I go home by the time the fruits will be over. Okay. So, but I feel very happy to see, and even my parents, they used to tell, somebody comes for plucking this one and all, then they say that my son has planted this, So many plants are there, or many trees are there like that. So, it takes a lot amount of time for growing, and there is no guarantee that we will get the fruit of it. Okay, it may be the next generation that the fruits of these things are received. But we have a responsibility to plant trees, because we are eating the fruits of the plants which we have not planted, isn't it? And it is our own. Before the people or the previous generation, they have planted the fruits or they have planted these trees for us. And it is our, so since if we are eating the fruits of these plants or trees, it is our responsibility to plant trees. So we have to make trees and give it to the next generation. But nowadays what happens is that now see like mostly children, they are not interested in these type of activities. Especially like if I ask you, how many of you want to become a farmer? If I ask you the students in a class and nobody will be saying yes. Or if I ask you, what do you want to become? Then nobody says that I want to become a farmer or I want to cultivate some trees and grow it. So these type of things, you know that because you are not going to get much money out of that. So doing farm work is not an easy job. There is a lot amount of hard work required, and as well as the earnings or the return that you are getting is not up to the mark. So like if you are doing how much amount of work that you are doing, that much amount of return you are not getting. But if you are working in a company or if you are doing a business, the money that you are investing and the effort that you are giving, but you will get a lot amount of return, So the profit that you are getting or the salary that you are getting will be higher, not like the farmers, So that is why people are not interested in working. But see, like one of the problem that the world is going to face in the future is the scarcity of food resources, scarcity of food. Now you see like if just in front of us there are some field is there, some land was there here just after the compound wall there was. So around 6 years back when I came here, that entire area was fully like forest like. So in that corner there was some mango tree and some peacock and all were sitting. And it was very nice to see those area when I entered into the gate itself, when I came first, and when I just entered first time into this campus, the first thing I saw was a peacock. And in our area, we cannot see peacocks just moving around. Only in that zoo and all, we can go and see the peacock. But it is not just moving around any. It is little not, like it is needs some little forest area. We just where people are together in that area, they don't, you know. But in our side, we don't see. My area. Some other area it is there, but I have never seen a peacock simply just roaming or simply on the, on the road or somewhere outside, just roaming like that. I have never seen. But I was very happy to see. You know, so it was very nice to see that. And there are so many monkeys sitting there, so many of animals and all are there. So it was very interesting to see. But now if you see, all that area has become fully covered with buildings. You know, and you cannot find any trees there. Now peacocks are also not there, you know. So peacocks are there that side, some they come into the compounds once in a while, but afterwards, after many years, what happens is that this number of trees will be getting cut, all the cultivatable land will be getting reduced, then number of buildings will be increasing. So you know, see, like global warming is there, you know. So one of the reason for global warming is the cutting of trees and making of buildings. Roads or other type of things are there. So where there is a tree is there. So that tree absorbs a lot amount of carbon dioxide and leaves oxygen and purify the the air. And recently I just saw in this mobile, and I clicked this, like I was checking the weather and the quality of the air. When I checked, then the Google is telling that in this place we cannot survive, you know. So the quality of air is very, very dangerous situation. You cannot survive in this situation. That is what Google says. If you search in your mobile, you can understand. So the quality of air, if you check in your mobile, if you search in Google about your quality of air, what quality is there? It is, they will say that it is not suitable for living. Such a air is there. Means that air is, because we are surviving, somehow we are surviving, that's all. You know, so the quality is not there, the air is not pure. You know, so we need pure air, pure water, pure atmosphere to live. And for that, one main thing that we need is the trees. You know, so we need trees. So you know, see, like if there are carbon, like the smoke is there. So that smoke is absorbed by the trees. The carbon dioxide is absorbed by the trees and they leave out oxygen. And you know, oxygen is always cool, you know. So if you are a very hot situation, very hot climate, but if you go and stand under a tree, you will find some relaxation, you know. So you feel a little comfortable feeling, even if it is entire area is fully covered with there are no trees, and if only one tree is there and very bad climate, very hot climate is there, and if you are going and standing under the tree, you will find it a very cool feeling will be there, you know. So this is there, and also the quality of the air is getting filtered, or it works like a filter. Trees are there, so it also helps in purifying the water, or there are so many advantages of trees. So it takes a lot amount of time for a tree to grow. So it grows slowly, consuming the earth. Consuming the earth means taking earth like mud. You know, so they are consuming. They are not much consuming means they are taking out the minerals and other type of things from the earth. So that is what it means about consuming the earth. Rising out of it, rising out of the earth. So like if you plant a seed, you are planting it under the earth. You know, so but it comes out of this, rise out from the earth. So we have to learn a lesson that if from the trees or the seeds are there. So if the seeds are the things that we throw out, you know. So it is kind of a waste like. But from there a new tree comes up. So like if you are eating a mango, so mango seed is there, you know. So you are not eating the mango seed, you will eat the mango and throw the seed. So it will fall somewhere and it will lie down there, it will be covered by the mud, and after that it will come up from there, you know. So it is coming out of the waste that we are throwing, or if the fruit is fallen down somewhere downside of the, or somewhere even some animals or some birds are eating, and after that they spit out the waste or the seeds, and from that these plants are coming, new trees are coming. So rising out of it, feeding upon its crust. Feeding upon means taking the minerals and food items from the food. The food that of the tree is received from the earth. So feeding out of the its crust. Absorbing years of sunlight, air and water. So it takes, and its food is the air, the sunlight. So it needs sunlight to grow. Isn't it? So if a plant has to grow, it requires, you might have studied about this photosynthesis and all. So it requires sunlight. So it absorbs the sunlight and convert the sunlight into energy and store it. You know, and with that energy, it grows. So it is the one who is generating energy. So we get energy from where we are getting energy?
Food.
From the food that we are eating. So this food, who is preparing this food?
Plants
are preparing. You know, so plants are making, collecting energy from the sun and storing it in the food. Okay, and that we are stealing, you know, we are stealing the food of the plants. It is that they are, you know, like this potato, you know. So potato is there. What is potato? You know, it is kept for the times like this. The potato plants, they store the food item for their future, and we are stealing that, you know. So such a way it is there, and we make use of it, though it is the storage. So it converts sunlight, air and water absorbed from the earth and convert it into energy, and we take out that and we use it. And it out of its leprous hide sprouting leaves. Leprous hide means it means about the root. It has got its roots are there. It is having very strong foundation and grows like that, and it sprouts. Leaves are there. Sprouts means to come out. Small leaves are coming out. Then, so hack and chop, but this alone won't do it. So here, not so much pain will do it. The bleeding bark will heal, and from close to the ground will rise curled green twigs. Miniature boughs, which if unchecked will expand again to former size. So here, see, like this is about the growth. The first one is about the growth of the tree is given in the first stanza. The next is about the cutting of it. You know, so hack and chop. If you cut it, chop it. You know, cut the tree. But this alone won't do. Just by cutting or chopping, then this tree will not die. Just if you give a chop or cut the tree, it will not die. Not so much pain will it do. So it will not give much pain also. It gives a pain to the, we don't know whether the trees are feeling pain or not, but according to the poet, he feels that, he says that when we are cutting the tree, it feels a pain, but it is not very much strong. Okay, that much, if you just give a cut, it will not give that much pain. The bleeding bark will heal. The bleeding, in the sense, if you make a cut on the tree, if you stab it with a knife, then what happens? A kind of liquid comes out, isn't it? So there are some, most of the plants are there. There is some type of liquid is coming out. So this liquid, the poet says that it is the blood of the, it is actually the blood of the plants. You know, so this blood comes out. So that is why bleeding. If your hand is cut, then from there blood will come. So that is what we call it as bleeding. So here, the plants, if you cut the tree, then from there are one type of liquid comes out. That liquid is the blood of the plants, and this bleeding bark will heal. Like if our hand get cut, then after some time the blood will come, then after that it will heal by itself. You know, so it will, first the bleeding will stop, then after that the wound will dry, then after that it will heal. So if you cut a plant, if you give one stab on the tree, on the bark, off on the branches or anywhere, if you cut, then that mark also will be there. That bleeding will stop after some time. Then after that, it will get healed by itself. Okay, there will not be any kind of issues. And from close to the ground, if you cut it fully, like full tree is cut, then a little bit area will be there under the earth. So close to the ground, there will be another sprout, another branch will be coming out. Will rise curled green twigs. So small branches, so small trees start coming up from there. under the earth, you know, so nearby the ground side. So if you cut it, we are cutting it when the tree is cut just above the ground level, we are cutting. So but there will be little bit portion downside of that. So from there another tree will come up. Miniature boughs which if unchecked will expand again. So these small plants which have come up, if you don't disturb it with a if you don't make any kind of disturbance, if you don't cut it again, then it will start grow again, and even it will grow into the size of the previous one, you know. So like the earlier one, how much big the tree was there, if you leave it just like that for many years, it will grow into even to that much big size. It will become just the how the older tree was there, up to that much size it will grow to former size. No, the root is to be, so now he is telling that these are the processes or these are the things that we do for cutting these trees, okay. So if, next stanza is telling about how the tree is killed, okay. So this is about we cut the tree. So if you cut the tree, nothing will happen to the plants, it will just grow, it will come up and it will become just like the previous.